Show you.
You ain't gonna dunk on the way out.
Oh!
What the fuck?
He tried the windmill on the Fisher Price. Twisted his shit.
Hey, oh, God don't hurt, bro. Hey, British. Nah, you don't understand, nigga, what I landed on, bro.
I'm trying to make y'all understand what I'm saying. Oh. I am life and I'm riding on growth.
Like, how you even do like a classical album cover? That shit is crazy. Just have somebody sitting on top of a piano or something.
I feel like it's really easy.
And you know, I was looking back at like who album covers is low key ass, except for like a couple. It's Jay.
Well, they're all just him.
It's just him. Yeah,
yeah,
it's just,
yeah.
It's like he's like, look that way, look this way.
Even like the Dynasty. He just threw up the rock and looked away.
Yeah, that's how the composer should do.
The Blueprint is like a aerial shot of him smoking a cigar. Yeah. Kingdom Come is him with the fucking fitted. Black Album, he's holding the fitted in the dark.
Yeah.
American Gangster, he's walking into a room.
Yeah.
Like his albums are kind of
like you didn't like I don't really think about it, but like they low key trash. Like there's no creativity.
In the back of his mind, he knew he was gonna do that commercial where he put all the albums together in one.
Yeah, that was in the Girls, Girls, Girls song.
It's like he had that shit all in the back of his mind, like he knew he was gonna.
But the Blueprint, I don't remember the Blueprint 3 was like it was just a bunch of mumbo jumbo.
Yeah, but yeah, this shit is like just photo shoots. It's like regular ass photo shoots.
We're just saving hella bread.
That's how like the composer should do. Just having it with a fitted, with a violin string hanging off his New York fitted room.
A violin string?
Yeah.
I ain't gonna cap to y'all. This wine kind of strong.
Wasn't it's it? Hidden. Birthday episode starting off good.
I'm finna chill on this shit.
What kind of wine is that?
Nigga, if I show you the bottle that this shit came, you know what? Bro, you ain't even gonna believe me, so I gotta show you.
You ain't gonna dunk on the way out.
Oh, shit.
What the fuck?
He tried the windmill on the Fisher Price. Twisted his shit.
Hey, oh, God don't hurt, bro.
Hey, I missed it.
I hurt my whole left side, bro. Hey, British.
Hey.
Forget the wine. Just come back.
I'm not even going nowhere, nigga. I go later, nigga. I done slipped on a whole Hot Wheel, nigga.
Oh, shit. He didn't land it on Legos and shit.
Nigga, I can't hit, bro. I know the playback is going to be so nasty for
that. That's just going to be hilarious.
Bro, no. I really feel, bro. Like, my shit really hurt her.
it's not an episode without you hurting yourself, low-key.
That last one was hilarious.
Yeah. He just not... He not gonna have the lights go out on him. That's just hilarious.
Really, it hurt, my nigga. Nah, you don't understand, nigga, what I landed on, bro.
I'm gonna tell y'all what I'm saying. When I came down,
All right, man, I'm cool. I just need a little moment of silence.
For sure. Hey, let's get it. Episode 5. Episode 5 started off with Jason busting his ass Yeah, we need to get some more subscribers just for Jason busting his ass.
Oh my god, bro.
Man, this shit about to live on the internet forever. All right, man. I'm about to start off with some more would you rathers. So would y'all rather know when you're going to die or know how you're going to die?
How?
You rather go how?
I want to know when.
What if that shit is like tomorrow?
It's good to know.
I feel like if I knew how, like, I'd be paranoid of like any type of situation that would be similar to that. Like if it's car crash, I probably would never drive again.
Just never ride. Just
yeah. And like that one day that you drive, like I'm driving like paranoid as fuck.
Yeah, exactly. You might get into a car crash and not even die because of how paranoid you are.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't want to know when. I don't know why. But that's why you got to live every day like it's
your last. If it's like 40 years in the future, you could like get to your full potential, I guess.
Or think about it. If you know how, then you can avoid it.
Yeah.
I actually read a book about this. And yeah, for sure wouldn't want to know when.
Yeah. All right, man. Y'all got some would you rathers, or y'all want to just get into these topics?
Man, I ain't got nothing today.
You got nothing? You ain't been playing randomly?
Oh, here we go. I got a good one.
Shit.
I actually used this before.
Off the top of the dome.
Would you rather fart really, really loud every 30 minutes, or would you rather fart silent but super deadly every 30 minutes? Like, no matter where you are, you always
fart. It's getting out no matter what? Like a cushion?
No matter what. Would you rather fart really, really loud but like it doesn't smell at all? Or would you rather fart really silent but it's super deadly? Like It reeks.
How reeky are we talking about?
Like bad to like where you're gagging. Where as soon as people smell it, you're gagging.
And it's every 30 minutes? Like
you know what? No, how about this? At really silent every 2 hours. Because obviously the smell is worse than being loud. So like don't matter where you are.
I want the deadly. Because it would be more of a defense mechanism.
Like I would go with
that's tough.
I go with silent.
Yeah.
I go with silent too.
Yeah. I could blame it on somebody else.
Nah, but the thing is you can't because they'll just end up going to you.
It'll catch on.
You just find
it'd be like, damn, why every time I'm around this fool? That shit just reeks every 2 hours.
But every day.
You know what though? I feel like you can explain your situation and be like, hey, it don't really stink, but you gonna hear some shit.
But if you fart really loud and you know that 30 minutes is coming, you could just like kind of like walk away somewhere.
Yeah.
Where there's no people and then
at least people like might still want to be around you. Like if your shit is reeking, ain't nobody gonna want to be around.
Because think about it, if you're with your girl, if you're with your girl, she probably don't want to be around you, but she could probably deal with the noise.
Yeah,
the smell is worse than waking
people up out of their sleep. It's like a motorcycle.
Jason's still thinking about it.
Yeah, you thinking hard as shit.
I kind of just had the realization that I might be the 30 minutes loud guy currently, like right now in my life.
but it don't stink at all.
Yeah, like in the morning, like from like the first hour when I wake up, I'm ripping ass like hard, like every, but it's like every hard. 7 minutes, every 7 to 10 minutes, I'm like, I get that off. And then the close, it's like thunder. Like the closer they get to, it's like contractions. Mm-hmm. Like the closer they are to get, that's when you know it's time to go. You know what I'm saying?
The baby gonna come out.
Yeah. So
that's a tough one. I think I might be the loud guy. I just fucking let it rip.
I want silent but deadly. Like I want, because it's that future, right? It's like that bad, but it's every 2 hours.
Yeah, so it's less occurrence throughout the day.
Yeah,
I take that.
Think about it. Like, what if you're somewhere stuck?
That's what I'm saying. You could be. Shouldn't
be rough either way it go.
If you're trapped in an air vent, you know what I mean.
What if you're on a flight? What if you're on
a flight? If you're on a plane, like a long ass plane ride. Like,
I can go to the bathroom.
But it's gonna seep out of the bathroom.
Nah, you're gonna be waiting to get into the bathroom, standing in the aisle, and it's gonna be your ass is gonna be right where people are sitting. Eye level.
I imagine these people are like wildly aggressive because they know the damage that they can cause. Like, you know those people that are just really mean about normal things? I think those are the people that have those types of conditions. Like, you're standing in line, you guys like, I need to use this right now. Like, that's the guy who's gonna fucking probably lay everybody out with a single fart. He knows. He's trying to protect us, and we think he's an asshole. Yeah. I don't know.
I never thought about it like that.
I don't know. I'm just saying. If we're on an airplane... I might chop a stewardess in the throat just to make sure that I secure everyone else's safety. You know, you got these babies on a plane.
Fool, you're going to get arrested.
Yeah, that's just a federal offense.
You just said, I'm going to chop a stewardess in the throat. Not only did you get arrested, but you just like laid a huge goose egg.
Now I'm still going to fart in the process.
Yep, mid-chop. Stinks that shit. Oh man. So did y'all get to the French Montana featuring Benny and Jadakiss?
I did, man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What y'all think?
I think French Montana, that nigga's just the king of horns. Like, this nigga do great with anything with horns on it. I really don't think he's gonna miss.
Yeah. I kind of started liking French Montana a little bit more. I don't know why. But this last project has been pretty dope. But I enjoyed Benny and Jada's verse. I don't know. Who do y'all think got who? Benny or Jada?
I think Benny ate.
Benny.
Yeah. I think Benny ate too. Like Jada, I think Jada started off stronger in his verse, but he kind of like fizzled out. And Benny was the opposite. Like he started off a little slower and the verse got better.
Yeah. I don't know. Jada's so consistent though.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like he just has
no matter what.
Yeah, he's just I was vibing with the verse, but like Benny was the one who's like,
Yeah.
I thought the song was whatever though.
Yeah.
It's funny because you say you kind of start liking French more. I kind of dislike him more.
I don't really check for him too much.
I think French is so full of himself.
Yeah.
Talking about,
I think
like,
so too. You know,
yeah, but I don't really. Yeah, like Jason said, I don't really check from either.
Yeah,
I listened to that song twice, and that's it. The other songs I listened to them multiple times.
Yeah, honestly, I never used to check for French. This is the only project that I actually listened to like around the time of release. But his past couple of projects, I kind of listened to a little bit more, but. I mean, I wasn't listening to him at all, pretty much, except for the singles before.
He's like a Khaled to me, except he like actually raps on his songs, but he's like a Khaled, just a bunch of features.
I kind of see him as like a Future.
Similar. I don't know because Future can carry a song by himself.
Yeah.
Like French, I don't think
French does better with features.
Yeah, I don't think French can carry a song by himself, and I don't even think he can carry a project by himself. Whereas like Future, he could carry a whole project by himself.
Yeah, I feel it.
Yeah, I feel that.
Yeah.
I'll ride with that.
That makes sense. And he has like hella features on this project too. Yeah. But you guys listen to Reasons, I Barely Miss.
Oh my gosh, that was like you told me about it. Like I didn't listen to it till yesterday. And Reason to me is the most underrated, underappreciated artist out there right now.
Yeah.
I love how he can take a song like this one, a meaningful song, and almost make it sound like a radio song. Mm. Like you can play on the radio, you can jam to this, you can vibe to this in the car, in the headphones, anywhere. Like I love this song.
Yeah, the song is dope. That shit kind of got that bounce to it too.
Exactly.
I like it. You could turn it up. It's one of those you could play it in the headphones or you could just crank it in the car too.
And how he changes cadences.
Yeah.
In the song.
Yeah. He's got that like that smooth Cali voice, like the way he flows on the track too. It's that stays consistent. He always brings like a calmness on the track that I like. I enjoy that. It's like similar to Schoolboy, but in a different way.
Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, I like the pockets that he finds on tracks, and he's really, I don't know, I really like his tone. Like his tone is just really. I'm trying to find another way to say it, but like he's.
Does he have like a raspy tone?
I wouldn't say that. I don't know. Not it really. It's just really easy to listen to. He's easy to listen to. Just.
Yeah. I don't know if it's like raspy. It's like a little bit raspy, but it's just more like a calmness. I don't know how to explain it.
It sounds like you smoke a lot.
Yeah. Like he chilling, laid back, but. You know, like,
and he from what, Delamo too?
Yeah, he's from Delamo. Or yeah, it's Carson. Carson.
It's Carson.
Yeah. Like he round the way for us. Delamo. So it sounds like he just down the street. He sound like the homie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's what it is. He just sound like the homie. Like,
I think that's the allure. I think that's the allure of all of TDE is they all sound like. The city that they from, and like everybody from, you know, SoCal is familiar with all of the areas, so it just sound like, oh, like this shit sound like making a right off the 91, or this shit sound like, you know, right off of Long Beach Boulevard, or you know, Kendrick sound like up Rosecrans, you know.
Yeah. It doesn't seem like he never runs out of things to talk about.
Yeah,
he can make anything like any situation into like a banger.
Yeah, I
like all his projects, so
yeah. Reason, I think Reason has yet to miss. I don't think I've come across a song where I'm kind of like, it's whatever. I think he's pretty consistent as far as making like good songs. Not every song is great, but I don't listen to a Reason song and like this is bad.
The first song he came out with, like I didn't think it was like great. I didn't think it was bad. I thought it was just a good introduction.
Yeah.
To his new project. But this one really got me hyped for like for his album.
Yeah.
I definitely he's like, I don't know. I need to listen to a lot more of him. I fuck with everything that I've heard from him, but it's just like, yeah, I definitely need to dive more into his projects and catalogs.
Yeah. He puts his projects together really well too. Like all TDE artists, they kind of like segue and stuff a lot, or like they have a consistent concept with their albums. So like the way he puts his projects together is pretty good too. I enjoyed it.
Yeah, this shit. It was.
It's gonna be in a rotation for sure. Did y'all get a chance to check out Lloyd Banks featuring Conway Menace?
Yeah, I did it for the Conway verse.
Yeah,
he's my favorite. That's my favorite out the whole Griselda clique.
Yeah,
I
have such a hard time choosing between him and Benny. Honestly, it's like whoever I'm listening to, that's who my favorite is at the time.
See, to me, it's Benny.
Yeah.
To me, it's Benny.
Yeah, I think like maybe like I know Benny's better, but I just like Conway more.
But see, I don't think that like. All right, I think Benny has like the better presence, and like he's smoother, and he's like the cooler one out of them, and like his flows are better. But like lyrically, I think Conway is better.
Conway is, yeah,
he a beast lyrically, but I don't know, man. Like for me, I go back and forth all the time with who's the better out of them two.
It's pretty close, but I don't know. To me, I'm like I think Benny might be better, but yeah, Conway's, that's my guy.
Yeah.
Let's talk about how Lloyd Banks just stays true to himself, though. Like, all his songs are just gritty and grimy and just rough. They're just rough and rugged. Like, I love that.
Yeah, don't change nothing about that.
That's for sure. I mean, Sean knows this. Like, Lloyd Banks will, like, pause, but he always have a special place in my heart, man. Like, Lloyd is just that guy to me.
Yep. Banks like, we'll get this out the way. Banks was always the best rapper out of G Unit. Always. Yeah. 50 was bigger, but Banks was the better rapper. I don't care what nobody says. And this year he's dropping Cody too. I don't know if y'all saw the announcement, but supposedly that's coming at the end of the summer real soon. And
is he independent?
As far as I know, yeah, he's not signed to like a major or anything. But I think last year, the first Course of the Inevitable album, that was in my top five.
Oh, yeah.
Albums of the year last year. That might have been my favorite. Magic kind of snuck in, but like at the end of the year, but yeah, Cody
just imagine if he gets like good enough funds for like a big, like, for good production on behind an album. Like, yeah, I think he could take it. Like right now he's just doing this all himself, you know?
Yeah. So
and you could tell, but like it still hits. But if he could get some good funding behind some good production, producers and engineers, oh my gosh.
Yo, one of the things, and I know this is not gonna be like most people don't think about this, but one of my like I'm always upset about this. It's when Kanye tried to sign Lloyd Banks to Good Music and 50 Cent.
I know.
And shit. Yeah. Bruh, could you imagine, like, with Good Music launching with fucking Pusha and Banks and Big Sean next to it, like, with Kanye production? Because, like, what was it? Started up with Fab and Swiss Beats and Kanye on Banks's album. That shit was crazy. But, bruh, if Banks would have been Good Music, that's, like, one of the biggest what ifs in hip hop for me.
I feel like there would have been, maybe this is just me being a devil's advocate or whatever, but I felt like there might have been tension with him and Sci-Hi.
You think so?
I don't know, maybe.
Bro, I feel like,
or like I wonder what type of bangers. I wonder what type of sparring would have occurred.
Oh yeah, bro, they would have brought some good ass music.
And then the freestyle that they did with the suits, I wonder what that would have been like.
Yeah.
And
that was right around the time of like Beamer, Benz, and Bentley, and started up. Like Banks was low key, like he kind of had like a good comeback. If he would have been able to get on Good Music,
it would have been crazy for Lamborghini Mercy with Lloyd Banks on it. Like,
bro,
that would have been wild.
So much, so much. Just hearing him, like, could you imagine Pusha, Banks, and Sci-Hi and Big Sean like just going back and forth or some shit? Like, that would have been dope, but
damn,
yeah, that's one of the things. Like, I'm all every time I listen to Banks, I'm like, fuck, if he would have just got on Good Music,
yeah. You got Chris Paul and Kobe, and Lloyd Banks, the Good Music, man. Freaking two things we'll never get
for real, though. Yeah. Yeah, Banks would have been big. So yeah, let's get into this West Coast Mount Rushmore.
Oh boy,
I'll start this.
You know what you should have had? You should have had like the little graphic, and you could put like Mount Rushmore and chop their heads off.
You know what? I looked online. I don't know. Maybe I'll be able to find one later. But I looked for something like that where I could replace the heads and like we could actually have like them carved into Mount Rushmore, but I couldn't find one that was consistent. It was like you could replace one head or replace two heads. I'm sure I'll find something.
Are we gonna be able to do it? Make this a Rushmore? You don't think we're gonna have like first team?
You
only get.
You could name some honorable mentions, but
hey, they already got a Mount Rushmore, Mount Westmore.
Nah. have y'all heard any of that?
No. No,
I don't think
they're on tour right now.
Yeah, that's a dope tour though. I ain't gonna lie, that's
a super dope tour. You think so?
Yeah, I mean, not the new shit, but like if they're playing like old shit, yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah.
If they're playing all their hits and stuff, which I'm sure they're going through a part of the set where it's old hits, but you know, that'd be a dope tour.
Mount Westmore.
Yeah, that shit like. 30 years too late.
Just a bunch of old heads.
Yeah. Hey, to each his own. I wonder if they could still rock it, though. I'm sure they can.
Hey, sometimes super groups in hip hop don't really work well.
Bruh. That shit rarely works well.
They just don't.
Yeah, look at The Firm. I mean, there's a lot of examples, but that shit just don't work.
Yeah.
Especially for already established artists. Shit doesn't work. That shit don't work at all.
You could make a comp like
Jason can't get over
Westmore. Yeah, Westmore.
So say what's on your mind, Jason.
Nah,
say what's on your mind.
Nah, cause
I'm low-key because you know I'm like in a I consider myself a musician myself, and so like and a nigga's kind of a part of a super group right now. So like. And niggas over here like, yeah, super groups don't work, my nigga. I'm over here like, Jesus Christ.
But that's different, though. Nah, it's just dudes that are past their prime trying to get together and bring back some, like, relevancy.
Get in the group back together, son.
Yeah, exactly.
Nah, but see, like, okay, from that perspective, if Brother Smack was to make it, y'all would be looked at as, like, a new group.
Yeah.
Like if once y'all gain popularity for all the new listeners, that looks like a new group.
It was just I guess you caught the moment on my face. So I was like, I had to come clean. Like I was like, oh gosh.
Yeah.
Nah, you guys are like, you're not like
y'all are
like,
still growing. You guys
are y'all are like the Slaughterhouse. Yeah. I wouldn't consider Slaughterhouse a super group.
Y'all are like 15 albums in trying to make a super group.
That's like
if Eminem and Jay-Z and Dr. Dre got together
today.
Like the Def Jam All Stars.
Yeah, fucking you know? Ludacris, T.I. and Jeezy come out tomorrow. Like.
Yeah, the Def Jam All Stars. The Def Jam All Stars.
Oh my god! Hey, they need to bring back those games at the record, though, for real.
Those games was dope. Didn't Fat Joe win like 15 times in a row or some shit?
Bro, so, yeah,
his team, yeah.
Hey, but it's remember, some shit where he talked about how Jay-Z cheated or some shit. Like,
no, remember, Terror Squad didn't even have to play.
They were getting like he said random ass NBA players. For one game, it'd be like one game. Stephon Marbury show up. Next game, you playing Kobe. Next game, you playing KD. Like what the fuck? Like how we supposed to practice for this, nigga?
Niggas in the garden the next night. Niggas
like you just show garden. Up and LeBron is here. Like yo, what the fuck?
Like what?
It's the record.
Like bro. You gotta go back to the project.
Yeah, like hey, where's Skip to my Lou, nigga? You bringing fucking LeBron out? Shit is crazy.
Imagine the people that couldn't go back to their neighborhoods after a couple of those games. Like,
hey, I don't care. I lose to Kobe. I don't care what nobody's talking about.
Like, Kobe's leaving in a limo, nigga. You're walking back home. Like, niggas yelling out their windows at you and shit.
Yeah, feet hurt like a motherfucker. And you're getting done dirty no matter what. Like, on a blacktop, nah. I'll be hot.
I ain't mean to segue like that, but Def Jam All Stars be somewhere.
That shit reminded me of the Def Jam Vendetta video game.
Dog, that's exactly what
they had. They had DMX doing kung fu and shit.
X called, give it to you. It's called, give it to you.
X versus Sticky Fingers and suck the nigga.
With the fucking graphics.
And they used to be in the middle of the club too. The speakers, you could throw somebody in the speakers. The speakers is booming and shit. Lights is going off. People in the back dancing and shit while DMX and Sticky Fingers is hip tossing each other.
Bro, niggas getting stomped out in the lugs.
Instead of lugs. Lugs and Tims. Fucking size 48 pants and doing roundhouse kicks.
X gonna give it to you.
That shit used to be wild.
Oh, bro.
Yo, Sticky Fingers was the most random character, too. Why was Sticky Fingers in the game? He had hella voice lines. She was crazy.
Yo. Oh, fuck that game. I was trash at that shit.
I beat that whole shit. The storyline was terrible.
Man,
that shit was funny. And that shit all started because you stepped on somebody's shoes in the fucking club too. Like a whole storyline of beating niggas up in random places started because you stepped on somebody's kicks.
The whole club just like made a circle. Be like, all right, let's get it on.
Start hitting the nigga head on the speakers and shit because somebody scuffed your Timbs.
DJ turned into an announcer.
Yo.
Club owners just dimmed the lights and center stage into the pit.
All right, y'all, it is what it is.
That shit was funny.
One of the arenas is the 40-40 club.
Hey, that would be, if they ever made a new one, I guarantee you 40-40 club is in it.
Yeah.
That should be hilarious.
Nah.
They need to make a new one. Fuck it. Yeah, we went a long way away from Mount Westmore.
Yeah. God, man. Start calling out.
Hey, nigga. I blame it on the Def Jam All Stars.
Oh, shit.
Hey, but if West. Nah. Well, shit. On the new Def Jam game, like, that'd be dope if you could, like, unlock Tupac's hologram.
You need to stop giving up ideas for free. Email them, nigga. Want a percentage.
He's not even in Def Jam.
It's like, he's not part of Def Jam.
Just throw him in there.
Yo, don't let Snoop get it. Snoop is Death Row now. He owns Death Row. Don't let him get wind of that shit. He doing everything right now.
What's he gonna do with that?
He'd make a Death Row video game, have fucking Daz and Corrupt rumbling
in the studio. Saying, like, I'm saying, man, what's he gonna do with Death Row? He bought all that shit for however millions. What's he gonna do with that?
Hey, tell me why one day I seen that nigga Daz running at the beach one day and that nigga was boxing and shit. Like,
Daz just retired.
Yeah, he did. He did just enough to try. He gonna be running on the beach a lot more.
Bro, he
gonna see him shadowboxing.
Shadowboxing. He might really be with that move. Good for him, though, man.
Hey, on a Vlad TV interview, he said he used to give Suge the business.
He did.
Hey, he said he used to toss Suge around.
I wouldn't be surprised, honestly.
Because Suge didn't pay him for like some of the records he produced. And like he said he used to go in there, he used to toss him around.
Whoop shit guys real
quick. I wouldn't lie. They both some pretty solid dudes, but
that's for sure. Yeah.
Tossing shit around is crazy.
Put him on the Mount Rushmore just for that.
Yeah, just for that. Just for tossing shit around.
All right, well that's one down. Let's figure out these other folks. We gotta find out who else laid hands on shit.
it's just everybody who laid hands on shit.
Hey, someone knocked him out.
Yeah, I think it was some random.
Oh, that was a random.
In Vegas, they just squared up my fountain there. Somewhere.
Yeah,
Let me see
who knocked out Shug.
What? He has an album on SoundCloud? Throw him up there.
You know who needs to be on Mount Westmore? Is the lady that Shug had in the chokehold dancing, doing the lean back. She in that for sure.
Let me see. Oh, yeah, it was just some random dude.
Yeah, it was a random
dude. Hey, his name is Greg the Barber.
Throw him up there.
Yeah. Greg the Barber got a face.
With his clippers.
Yeah. Greg the Barber up there.
Hey, hold on. This is the dude that knocked out Shug.
Oh, he fucking that dude hairline up, bro.
he got that I knocked Shug out face on that picture, too. That's two down.
That's two. We almost there.
Oh man!
Yeah, are you starting this off?
That's crazy. Yeah, yeah. I'll start it off. I'll start it off seriously. All right. So we're gonna do the four members, and then we could do some honorable mentions. We'll discuss it later after that too. My first obvious pick is Dre. And
before we start this, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Does Jay-Z count?
No, this is West. Yeah, Jay-Z from Brooklyn, New York.
But.
I don't care what he wrote. I don't care what he wrote. No. I see where you're going.
I just had to, all right.
I see where you're going. And okay. No, it don't count.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. It's a lot of writers on Dre shit, but
that's like putting Snoop on the Mount Rushmore of New York hip hop because he stomped the buildings.
I'm okay with taking it here.
You okay with that?
If Jay-Z can be used today, I will. That's a fair fair trade.
All right. They stomped the fuck out the buildings too.
Bro, that's
Windows 95 graphics.
Hey, I know niggas was mad at the 90s.
Like three King Kong. Hey, could you imagine New York rappers in front of a TV watching that shit? Nah, hey, son. You could just knock the buildings over, son.
There's some gators.
We gotta go get them niggas.
Hey, you know what's funny though? The dudes that was most mad were dudes that were not even like the big hitters of New York.
Yeah, yeah, because they probably didn't understand. They probably were still goons. Like I know, I've seen like Nori talk about it, but
yeah,
Nori was like he didn't even know he was famous. He was still slanging, and he had a classic album that dropped, did like a million sold, and he was still in the streets.
Nori, I just laugh when I think of Nori, man.
New York people are so aggressive, bro. I could imagine. Them watching that shit premiere on BET. And that shit called New York, New York.
That nigga said, I want to kick down the Empire State Building.
they made LA, CNN,
LA is low key fire, though.
Yeah, that shit is.
Like, and that embodies New York, because the way they rock, like the way they put the song together, just is so New York.
Yep,
I gotta hear that shit.
LA is fire.
CNN has some dope shit. Nori has some dope shit.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my god. He said, oh my god. He can't take Nori seriously.
No, I can't. It's just, it's so, I just think of Nori saying refrigerator.
And my favorite, my favorite thing every time Nori say something fucked up, you go, you know, I'm dyslexic. Yeah. You can't use that for everything, bro.
He really does say that.
Dyslexic. He be fucking up everything.
It's not like he's reading though. He just, he just don't know. Yeah. He just don't know.
It's hilarious. I love trick chats.
Hey, the wildest thing is Nori's teeth, man.
I never noticed.
Bruh, Nori's got the fakest white teeth you've ever seen in your life.
He got them veneers.
He got the chompers, bro.
That's funny. Yeah, man. I never noticed.
It's the flex.
All right, man.
All right. So, all right, I'm going Dre off top. Responsible for NWA, Introduction to Snoop, Death Row, most famous record label of all time, Pac's resurgence after he got out of jail, Eminem, 50 Cent, Game, who held the West on his back for fucking 5 years by himself, pretty much. And then he takes Kendrick and pushes Kendrick to a new level. The Chronic might be the best album of all time. That's in the discussion. Good Kid, Mad City might be best album of all time. That's in a good discussion. He's responsible for the sound of both of those. So I think Dre goes without saying. My second pick is Snoop. Another cliche pick. But he's like really the first artist from the West to create like a crazy wave by himself. NWA was first, but they were a group. But Snoop created like this crazy wave as a solo artist. Co-wrote The Chronic, and then his move to No Limit was dope as fuck too. I don't think that gets talked about enough because he only had what, two albums under Death Row, I want to say, and then he went on a crazy run with No Limit, which was dope. But he can make anything sound good. I mean, he's got shit like Deep Cover and then Sensual Seduction. So like his range is insane, and he probably the most famous hip hop artist of all time. Fourth spot, I got Kendrick. He's the most lyrically inclined rapper from the West. Conceptually, everything. The Good Kid, Mad City persona, I don't think that gets brought up enough. Before Kendrick, if you were a West Coast rapper, you had to be a gangster or act like you was a gangster. Once Kendrick drops, it's okay being the good kid in the Mad City. It's okay with being the artist that just grew up around gangbangers. You didn't have to actually be a gangbanger. You didn't have to act hard all the time. You could be that artistic person that just like saw that shit, you know? You didn't have to really be in it or act like you were in it. He continuously pushes the culture with every release. I don't think anybody's doing that right now except for him. And I believe TDE is probably the most talented record label in West Coast history. Once J-Rock opened that door, Kendrick kicked that shit off the hinges. And my last one, probably my only maybe controversial one, but maybe not, I got Nate Dogg. So I got Nate Dogg because I consider him the all-time king of hooks. He's that G-Funk sound. That's Nate Dogg shit. I think that's what he's mostly known for. And he was not only, you know, just a West Coast artist, but he worked with people like Fab, Pac. He worked with 50. He worked with a lot of people from other, Jermaine Dupri. He was T-Pain before T-Pain, without all the gimmicks and shit. He was just himself. There was a time in like the 2000s where he was just on every hook, it seemed like. So I think Nate Dogg deserves a spot. He's got hooks on All About You, 21 Questions, Area Code, Oh No with Pharrell Monk, and Mos Def, Till I Collapse, Regulate, Can't Deny It with Fab, Lay Low, Bitch Please 2. And yeah, that's pretty much it. My honorable mentions though go to Cube, E-40, Too Short, and Tyler the Creator. I don't think Tyler gets brought up enough as a West Coast artist because he doesn't have that signature style. But I mean, what he's doing right now with the popularity, with the awards, with the creativity, he's he definitely deserves an honorable mention.
Do these artists have to be born in the West Coast?
I went with born, but it just depends on like where they made their stamp or whatever you think. Like if you look at that artist and think, okay, that's West Coast, fuck it.
So why didn't you put Pac up there?
I don't see him as like exactly. I don't see him as a purely West Coast artist. I looked at Born when I was making my list.
And you know what I was going to, before we started,
Not mad at that though.
I was going to ask if Pac is considered a West Coast artist before we started because of.
I personally look at Pac as just a hip hop artist. I don't think he belongs to a coast.
I look at him like, I mean, you're right. He is just a hip hop artist, but I think he really put West Coast on the map when he just went ahead and took on the whole entire East Coast. And I think that really brought eyes on West Coast music because like everybody was talking about New York and he just went at these guys, at Nas, at Jay, at even DMX, Biggie, obviously. So I think that brought eyes on, Mobb Deep. I think that's the only reason, I guess the way I look at it, and I'm actually surprised he didn't put a Bay Area rapper up there. Cause like, I look at Mount Rushmore as like the forefathers, you know, like of whatever subject you're trying to bring. So, I would put, it's kind of hard, but I would put either Too Short or E-40 on there. I definitely think Easy, because if it wasn't for Easy, like Cube and them, and you know,
NWA would have probably never got on if it wasn't for Easy. So I'm
So 100%. I mean, I think I'm just gonna go ahead and put Too Short, Easy, Pac, and I'm gonna put Snoop as well.
Yeah.
And then your honorable mentions to me, I could put like Cube, Nate Dogg. Nate Dogg is honorable mention, even though he is the king of hooks. I just don't think like he is from the East Coast, but like you said, to me, Nate Dogg is just the embodiment of the most versatile artist that you can put him on any song, any genre, and he could just make a hit out of it.
Yeah. So now that when you bring that up, the forefathers. So when you say forefathers, are we thinking like when West Coast hip hop was first put on the map and you taking those people like, in that era, or are we considering Styles too? Because I consider Kendrick a forefather because of how he changed the way you can do West Coast music.
Yeah, so, but Kendrick isn't done with his career to me yet. So like I think of like if you take any, to me it's like if you take any of these artists out of the West Coast history, you can't talk about them. You can't talk about West Coast hip hop without mentioning these guys.
Yeah.
So like to me, you can't talk about West Coast hip hop without mentioning Eazy-E.
Yeah.
Or, you know,
E-40. I mean, I'm not mad at E-40 and Too Short. Those, you know, those are people that pop up immediately.
Yeah. Like I think Bay Area music is like is definitely like super important to like West Coast hip hop.
Yeah,
it's just a different style. It's just a different movement that they brought.
Yeah.
You know, they may not be the best out of the West Coast, but I mean,
just a different aspect. Yeah. And look at how many, like, we're talking about hits and we're talking about visibility, you know, shit like that. Like, E-40 and Too Short brought a lot of attention to the West.
But I do agree. I do agree that Pac isn't a West, like, he's kind of like Kendrick. Kendrick to me isn't a West Coast artist. He's a hip hop artist.
Yeah.
You know? So to me, but yeah, you're right. Pac isn't a West Coast artist, but yet he really brought eyes on West Coast hip hop.
Yeah, and I don't think a lot of people see Tyler as a West Coast artist either, even though he is. But yeah.
And that's why you have to put Game on there as well, because before Game, no one was really talking about West Coast. They were, but then there was a dry spell.
There was a very, very large
gap. Game for a long time.
Yeah, and then Game came out, and then now all eyes were back on West Coast hip hop.
Yeah, for sure. You and know? He took on the biggest fish from the East too.
Yeah,
He did.
And won.
Yeah. So he that's did. Why, that's why, like, I think, like, that's, to me, Game and, like, Pac are both, like, they brought eyes to hip, to West Coast hip hop.
Yeah. So who's your four again? Just run it.
It was, I'm going to say Too Short, Eazy-E, Pac, and Cube, because, man. Oh, no. Sorry. Snoop. Because you're right. Snoop is more important to West Coast than Cube. But Cube is, like, to me, the next honorable mention. Like, he, yeah. You could, you know. And then, obviously, Game and Nate Dogg. And
so, I think if we're doing, like, an all-time list, Cube is higher than Snoop. But yeah, if we're doing, like, a Rushmore, then yeah. I put Snoop a little bit, you know, a little bit higher. But, yeah, for yeah, sure.
I completely agree.
Yep. Cube definitely deserves, you know, his flowers. There's so many people from the West, like, so many people. It's hard to choose just four. And even with the honorable mentions, like, you can name off 10 people and still be missing somebody.
Yeah.
Like, look at, I hope I don't take your pick or one of your picks, Jason. I don't think I am, but look at J-Rock. In between Game and Kendrick, or not even that, even if you want to just look at post-Game, J-Rock was the next one to bust the door open. Mm-hmm. And he opened the floodgates for TDE to be able to be successful. We don't get Schoolboy, we don't get Kendrick, we don't get Ab, you know, without J-Rock yeah. doing what he did, you know?
Yeah.
That definitely deserves a mention, you know?
Yeah, because there was quite a few artists after, like, Game. Like, I mean, remember, like, Gorilla Black, even though he didn't hit it off, but it allowed people to, like, record labels to be like, oh, let's go back to the West Coast. Like, mm-hmm. maybe gangster rap is back in now, you know? Yeah. Because for quite a while before Game, it was, like, South, Southern music.
Yeah, really South, because once Wayne popped, then it was, like, mm-hmm. all eyes is on the South, mm-hmm. period. Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, we lost you for a second.
Wait, what's he laughing at?
Hold on, we lost you for a second. Hold on. That red wine was good, huh? That glass of red wine got the homie. Oh, he ain't even done. Oh, shit. Oh, you know, drink champ.
Big ass glass, man.
Yeah, Jason doing a whole different podcast.
I'm doing a whole different segment right now.
Man.
Nah, you guys kind of fucked me up now with my four.
Now say your original.
Just go off your original four.
Because I think we each have a different
well, they're kind of the same thing. I probably got one different.
Yeah, that's cool. And it could be, you could have the same people, but for different reasons.
It's, I think, well, for sure, Pac for sure. Nate Dogg for sure. DJ Quick. I'll just throw him in there.
Yeah.
And, y'all go ahead and say Kendrick. I throw Kendrick in there. You guys, for the same reasons, like, I don't know. I know DJ Quick was involved in everybody's shit, you know?
Yeah, he definitely contributed to that West Coast sound after Dre and Daz, you know, Daz and Quick is right there as far as West Coast sound goes, for sure. Yeah.
And then as far as, like, the production and, like, instrumentation, you know? Like, I could, his influences are everywhere, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I think Cube, because of just, like, type of longevity, you know?
Yeah.
We
stopping it. Are we there yet, though? For Cube. The Fridays was cool. We gonna rock with the Fridays, but after Are We There, yeah, we stopping.
See,
with
that's so tough. Just because he did the Fridays makes me want to bump Snoop out and put Cube in.
Yeah, hey, Cube. Yeah, uh-huh. Like multimedia, putting the West on the map. Like,
Damn, did I say Snoop? I didn't say Snoop, huh?
You just say Snoop or Dre.
Damn, see, like, and that I was fucked up because it's like, I know Snoop is definitely it. So, but I don't want to get rid of Pac, and that's the thing, like.
Yeah.
So, but if I had to, just to be different, I would say Snoop, Nate Dogg, Quick, and I'm gonna still throw Kenny in there.
Okay. Yeah. So with Pac, you guys consider Pac as like a West Coast artist.
Yeah.
I do. Yeah, 100%.
Okay. So my thing with Pac is, and he's top three of all time. So me saying this is not a slight to Pac. I feel like he rode a wave that was already there after he got out of jail. I don't think that was like, if Death Row doesn't pick Pac up, is he making that type of music?
Mm.
Is he gravitating towards that West Coast sound? As good as he sounds doing it, and that's like, to me, that's like one of the biggest, that's the biggest peak of any rapper, is that last month, you know, the 9 months between him getting out and him dying. That's like the peak of any rapper. But if Suge and them are not the ones who pick him up after he gets out, does he gravitate towards that style of hip hop? Because all of his albums before that are, they have some similar tracks, but the sound is very different to me.
I mean, that's kind of like, it's kind of unfair to say that, because you could say that about almost like a lot of these artists. Like, what if Dre didn't push Kenny to, like, you know?
Yeah, but Section 80 sounds a lot like Good Kid, M.A.A.d City, and so does Overly Dedicated. Like, he did take that to like the next level, for sure. And like with Eminem, Infinite sounds a lot like, you know, those first couple albums too.
But I mean, I also, like, you know, he did, like, didn't he kind of grow up, like, not grow up, but didn't he have a lot of, like, he was living in the Bay for a while. Yeah. I think, but the thing with Pac is he just wasn't just one style. He was just multi, he didn't stick to one style. I mean, I still would consider him hip hop, West Coast, just because, like, of how much he pushed that. Mm-hmm. But I mean,
I'm just I'm just being devil's advocate with Pac. I know that's always a discussion on if he's actually West Coast or not.
They recently did the biggest hip hop tournament of all time on this YouTube page, and the finals was Tupac versus Eminem, and Eminem ended up winning.
Wow.
Yeah. It's the biggest hip hop tournament of all time. I mean, I'm not either. I personally think Pac is the greatest of all time, but
I honestly, to me, I'm be real, whoever I'm listening to last, that's who my goat is. Like, whether it's Nas, Big, Jay, Pac, you know, Kendrick, M, like, whoever I'm on at the time, like, if I'm running back a bunch of old Eminem albums, like, man, ain't nobody better than this motherfucker. If I'm listening to Pac, I'm like, oh, can't nobody do it like Pac. He's a fucking goat. If I'm listening to Jay shit, I'm like, oh, Jay, that fucking flow is insane. Can't nobody do it like that, you know?
Yeah. I don't know who's the best.
I think Pac to me. I've always said Pac to me is the best.
Yeah. I think we've reached a point in hip hop to where, like, there is no best. But that's just my opinion. I think we've reached that point of, like, how rock is. Like, you ask people, you know, you could take 20 people and ask them who their goat is in rock, and you're going to get 20 different rock bands. And I think we're finally reaching that in hip hop. Early 2000s, I mean, everybody was Pac, Big, Jay, and Nas, you know, but
now it's just,
I think the game has finally reached that point where it's like, you can't really say. Like, everybody's going to have that one favorite, but you can't really say. Like, if I had to pick, I would pick Kendrick. But Kendrick has those elements of everybody, you know, who's in the top five.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's gonna stay Kendrick for a while too.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people go back and forth with Kendrick even being the best right now.
Yeah, like you're never gonna get with Kendrick, especially like with his last album. He fell down a lot of lists because they just don't understand it. He fell down the list. Yeah. I think this double album wasn't as successful as people thought it was going to be.
Yeah, I feel like it's giving me that To Pimp a Butterfly feel, where it's like everybody hated it for 6 months, and then like a year later, everybody started appreciating it. No. I got a malfunction in the back.
I feel like it's appreciated, but these young niggas are still like, nah, nigga, don't slap. Like, we hear you, but you didn't, like, I don't know. These young niggas is different, man. They like smart and disrespectful, like.
Yeah, but like for us, it don't seem like it, but it low-key is like a new era. Like Kendrick and Cole and Drake are considered like OGs.
I like the album. Like, I like the album. I just don't consider it a classic. But I do like the album a lot.
Yeah, no, it's a really good album. I wouldn't consider it a classic, though. But, I mean, you can't make everything
exactly,
you put out
that, be exactly. a classic, period. Exactly. Exactly. Like, but I think he wanted to be like, because, you know, it was a double album. And I think every great artist has a classic double album. And I think he tried to do that. But I just think, yeah, it's like Jason said with these young dudes. I just don't think they appreciate it.
Yeah. But like, we appreciate the context it was given, but we won't play it again. Like, like, fuck y'all, little dude.
Yeah, but it seems like... That's the thing, though, like with Kendrick, it's like, even though this is not necessarily a classic album, I feel like it opens a lot of doors for a lot of different conversations for a person like a Boogie, or, you know, somebody who actually is open about like their feelings and shit like that. I feel like it just, even though it's not a classic album, it just opens so many doors. It's still pushing the culture forward, you know?
Yeah, I agree. I definitely agree.
A lot of people say like especially, you know what it is, though? It's not the fact that it wasn't, like, you know. It's the fact that a lot of people waited 5 years. And it's the amount of time that we waited for an album and for it not to hit how people thought it was going to hit.
Yeah.
You know? And then a lot of people go back to, like, that's why a lot of people consider Pac the greatest. He went out of jail, and in 2 weeks, he created All Eyes on Me. You know? Even Daz was like, he was like, we gave him this beat in about an hour. He knocked out that song and he said next. And he was like, damn, okay. Yeah. And made another beat, boom. I think it's the fact that, like, we waited so long for this Kendrick album, you know, and it just didn't hit like it should have.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I do feel like that. Like, if it had only been like a year or two, then maybe it would have got a better reception. But who knows?
But that's okay with me, though, because, like, I like the fact that, like, I mean, do I want to wait another 5 years for a Kendrick album? Hell no. Hell no. But like, if he, like, waits 2 years, I'm okay with that. You know? Yeah.
No, keep going. I'm sorry.
Like, you know, like with Drake, he puts out something like so often, but like we get. Quantity over quality, you know, so yeah. I'm okay with waiting, you know, but let's not wait another 5 years though. That's all.
Yeah, five is too long, but I feel like there's only been a few artists who could constantly put out music and it'd be really good. I think that's Pac, Wayne, 50, and Jay, where they releasing every year, and X, of course, but that didn't last as long. But for a minute, you know, two albums a year was X and Jay. That's what they were doing.
Real quick, I want to ask you, which one do you think is better, the Chronic or the Chronic 2000?
Chronic 2000. See,
yeah, I agree. I say the same thing.
That's where I lean towards, but I think I lean towards it because that was our era. We were still kind of growing up. Like, it might have been, we were what, like 12 when that came out. So it was like we were growing up listening to that, where we had to go back and listen to the Chronic. So it sounded outdated. But like when I listen to the Chronic now, I think that that is possibly the greatest album of all time. I think it's in that three range. I think Good Kid, Mad City, The Chronic, and Ready to Die. You don't think The Chronic is possibly the greatest album of all time,
Jason? I don't put it up
there. I thought it was better than Chronic 2000.
Really?
That Chronic 2000?
Chronic 2000. Hey. I mean, to me, that's top 10. But that, you know, us being from the West Coast and being in that era.
But here's the thing.
I think that The Chronic is really better, though.
At our time, though, the production was better. You know, the engineering was better. It's like when NBA players, like NBA players of today are better than NBA players of like back then, you know? I do think the Chronic 2000 is better.
Yeah. I usually lean towards 2001, but like listening to both of them now, where both of them kind of sound, you know, a little dated, I feel like the Chronic is probably better. But yeah, like if you put a gun in my head, I probably lean towards 2001. But if I'm making a list, I'm probably putting the Chronic above 2001. That's where I'm at with it. It's so close. That's another thing to where I'm listening to it and fucking, you know,
exposed. You probably just got done bumping it.
Yeah, when I'm listening to 2001, I'm like, oh yeah, this shit better. But when I'm listening to The Chronic and I'm like, damn, this shit came out in 92. Could you imagine like how crazy niggas was going in 92? Like when you listen to 36 Chambers and you know nobody has ever rapped like Wu-Tang, and this is the first time somebody's hearing some shit like this, like imagine like the fucking wave when Cream comes out. Like, could you imagine being in New York in 92 when Cream comes out? Yeah. Like the energy was probably insane. That was like, you know, us being the age, you know, where Good Kid, Mad City, we know the way that shit happened.
Didn't Jay-Z wrote Still Dre?
He wrote Still Dre. He also wrote The Watcher. The Watcher.
Yeah, that. But to be honest, you know what's funny is like when Dre spits his verse, that sounds exactly what Jay would say.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah, you could definitely tell. But yeah, he also co-wrote The Watcher with Rakim, and then The Watcher Part Two, which is on the Blueprint, is Jay featuring Dre and Rakim. So they did both versions, which is dope.
Yeah, that's why I was trying.
Fight with that. Like, which one is better, The Watcher Part One or Watcher Part Two?
Oh man, that's tough.
Yeah, I love The Watcher Part Two.
Yeah,
so do I.
It's crazy. It's
crazy.
But I'm gonna, you know what? I like The Watcher Part Two, but I'm gonna go with The Watcher Part One.
Yeah, Part One is, that shit is flawless, man. But I think both of them are great. Jay's verse on the Part Two is probably like why I like it so much, because Jay goes fucking crazy on that.
Fucking nuts.
Yeah.
What's the greatest? So Jason, what's the greatest West Coast hip hop album of all time?
Album of all time.
I think we could at least come up with a 5 to 10 together.
Or one that you really think highly of.
It's between, just from how it hit, like, I want to say probably Doggy Style.
Yeah.
Just from.
I'm mad at that.
Maybe. If I had to stand on a hill.
You stand on Doggy Styles here?
Stand on Doggy Style.
Yeah. So, all right. So, Chronic 2001, Doggy Style, America's Most Wanted, Good Kid, Mad City.
Okay.
Is that?
I'm going to say the documentary. I think that's the greatest hip-hop album.
Okay.
That to me, and that's the documentary is the greatest. I could go song for song with any with Doggy Style, with the Chronic, like, because it embodies the West Coast.
Man, more yeah. than the Chronic, more than 2001.
More. You know why? You know why too? Because Chronic 2001, like, it was so reliant on features. You know?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, and like great, and documentary, yeah, but like that was Game, like really like putting the West Coast on his back. And you know me, you know how I feel about Game now. But like, I think he really took pride in like putting the West Coast on his back and bringing it back. I think you go song for song on the documentary.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, I think the documentary is a classic. I don't think there's any skips on that. But it's like, all right, so documentary would probably have been like my 6 to 7 range with like Quick is the Name, Death Certificate, and damn, Death Certificate might be in place of America's Most Wanted. Yeah, West Coast got a lot of shit.
Forgot about
tell you that much. Tell you that much.
And damn, and we ain't even talked about niggas like Razzcaz.
Oh yeah, hey, no. Razzcaz is out because Game fucked him up in the club. So.
Well,
everybody who got beat up is just out of all of our list. Or
just, just how you go throw up Daz because he was tossing Chug.
Yeah, damn.
Yeah. So like,
now right, Razzcaz, so, yeah, Razzcaz. Okay.
How many Tupac albums make that list? A top 10 West Coast list? Is it just All Eyes on Me, or are we looking at Don Caluminati?
All Eyes on Me, Machiavelli. And then Are You Still Down?
I'm not mad at that.
You think all of those crack a top 10?
All Eyes on Me, 100%.
All Eyes on Me, for sure.
Machiavelli, too. To me, there's no skips on Machiavelli.
I ride with that.
Yeah, there's no... I think we can name 10 hip-hop albums with no skips, for sure.
Are You Still Down is a double album, too. Yeah. And there's no skips on that.
All Eyes on Me is a double. He got a lot of. He was making double albums even after he's dead.
Yeah. Better Days.
Better Days is a double. Yeah.
He was still stacking. Yeah.
Hey, he was still going at Jay in that song.
Yeah.
He was already dead. He was still going at Jay.
Yeah. That's real wild.
Oh man. But yeah, I mean, like,
Jay felt like, damn.
I mean, the first NWA album has to go up there.
Of course. Yeah. That's one that I don't think I mentioned in my top 5. So, yeah, I would have to push that one up for sure.
We're not going to get Ice-T No Love?
Ice-T for sure gets love. I just don't know if it's hitting that. That's like doing a top 5 for New York and doing KRS-One.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah,
like, he's for sure opened the floodgates for all of that, but like, was he really on that level?
Yeah,
like,
no, you're right. I agree.
And I know a lot of people from that era would say yes. Like,
I'm man sure was like a, breaking.
Respect. He's one of those. I see one of those for sure.
Man, hey, real quick though. Hey, real colors. Quick though. Colors. Would you consider Bone Thugs West Coast?
No,
I was gonna say
it's Midwest.
They're from the Midwest.
Style, how they got
their whole, yes, bro.
Yeah, their whole so style many, is for sure. But
bro, Bone Thugs at man.
I can't, because then if we consider Bone Thugs Midwest, then you got to consider like people like Scarface is like New York, like because it's that style, but they still telling their story from where they from. You know,
hey, imagine.
I don't think we can open that door.
Imagine if West Coast hip hop was this gate and people were fleeing away to come into the West Coast. Imagine how many people Sean would turn away.
I'm trying. Hey, stop. Imagine right both
of us, please, we got nowhere to go. Sorry.
You not West.
Y'all got Dickies, Shades, y'all even got Preston.
All right. If we doing that, if we doing that, then 50 is West.
Nah.
He gangsta rap over Dre beats, over like those type of styles with the heavy bass. Nobody in New York was rapping like 50. Not that gangster.
I teach you.
50 was Pac 2.0.
You willing to die on that hill?
100%. 50 was Pac 2.0 like a mug. He was not a East Coast style of an artist. He was not rapping like Nas. He wasn't rapping like Jay Big. He was rapping like Pac and Snoop and all of them niggas.
You're not wrong. I just don't like it.
Yeah. It's just because he was with Interscope.
Nah, he was doing that before. Like, look at Life on the Line and Not Like Me. It's the same content. He was just heavily influenced.
The Quran, what was that? What was that?
That was Not Like Me.
Okay.
Yeah, that was when he was with the record label before he got shot.
Oh, when he was on Jam Master Jay's record label.
Yeah, I don't remember. It was like, yeah, somewhere with like Capitol or something. I don't remember off the top of my head. But yeah, he was with another record label. He was still doing that gangster shit. He was 50 was West Coast artist from fucking New York.
I guess like Bone Thugs, they had their own style because they weren't Midwest to me. Like they were rapping all fast.
Yeah, they were different, you know? For sure. They were different, yeah. For sure. I think they started that type of, like, you know, they made a lane for that style of rap. You know, yeah. They definitely create their own lane, but I still consider them Midwest.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, no, man. That Pocket 50 shit was crazy.
That's shit you don't think about till you start talking.
I know you got so many. You got even for example, like the Dog Pound, Dog Food. Man, that album slaps.
Yeah, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Even Snoop has multiple. Like, I even like Paid the Cost to Be the Boss was my shit growing up. Like,
hey, love
that shit. Don't got no skips to me. That shit ain't got no skips.
That's true.
I downloaded that shit on LimeWire.
Yeah, 100% free.
Yeah. Yeah, the East Side is too. Holy Love, Trey D. Yeah, that's another one, man.
Corrupt really, had a couple too.
Yeah, he really did. Snoop Dogg really did pave the way for a lot of like.
Yeah, that artists, old Dog Pound and G Funk and all that shit. Like,
yeah,
that's true, man.
Warren G and Snoop really like. Yeah. You know, then Nate Dogg, of course, like really pushed that shit.
Oh yeah, man, Nate Dogg.
I was gonna say, yeah, that's true. Hey, but when Snoop went over to No Limit, though,
that he was putting out bangers. That shit,
the Dog Father.
Yeah, Dog Father. Game is to be told, not to be sold. Or again, to be sold, not to be told. Yeah.
Snoop was incredible. That was right after the collapse of Death Row, right?
Yeah, yeah. Well, I think Snoop left before the collapse, but yeah, all that shit happened so fast. Pac was only on Death Row for 9 months. Like, that's insane.
Yeah, that's crazy.
That shit seemed like years.
What's your favorite Snoop album?
My favorite is, I think it's Doggy Style. And then right after that is, it's probably Paid the Cost to Be the Boss right after Doggy Style, just because of the era.
Hey, my shit, Blue Carpet Treatment. That shit.
Yeah, Blue Carpet Treatment was hard too. I think that shit hard.
Hey, that
I'm not a big fan of that album.
Yeah,
I think it's the nostalgia and just I don't know, man. For the nostalgia, bro. That album, I had a lot of great moments in my life to that album, bro. Like that shit. Yeah,
I thought that. I mean, I didn't. That album,
yeah, look, Blue Carpet Kingdom, hey, don't really cross my mind, but like,
hey, but don't forget
that about era it, bro, though, that yeah, like from hey, the church remember, to the palace, like that shit went crazy.
Hey, yeah, Vato was on crazy. That song,
Vato was on Vato. There, yeah, yeah, shit dog, went crazy,
yeah. Yeah,
he had a few. Hey, didn't he just come out with an album too?
Yeah, Back on Death Row. It was actually a lot better than I thought it was going to be. But I gave it a listen. Just
hey, Malice in Wonderland wasn't that bad.
Nah, Rhythm and Gangster wasn't terrible Rhythm and Gangster, either.
It wasn't that bad because wasn't that produced by Pharrell?
A lot of it, yeah. Snoop, man, Snoop's run is crazy.
The Last Meal?
The Last Meal, that's one of the ones too. The Last Meal is in my top five of Snoop albums for sure. I love The Last Meal.
Yeah, that's I forgot about that.
Then he came back and did the shit with Wiz and Snoop's run is crazy when you think about it. But yeah.
Ego Nobody tripping. Talks about that reggae album though.
Nah, we gonna skip over that shit.
Snoop Lion?
What about the Dogumentary? Nobody talk about that shit either. Blue Carpet Treatment, Rhythm and Gangsta. Yeah, my shit. Yeah, The Last Meal was my shit. They had that. What was that song? Stacey Adams with Cocaine.
Yeah. Oh shit!
Yeah, Stacey Adams with Cocaine was hard. Lose Control with Butch Cassidy.
Who's the greatest West Coast hip hop? I don't want to say disser, but like, you know what I mean? Like,
I mean, shit.
Probably Gabe.
Yeah, it's got to be
over Cube.
Yeah,
300 bars and running like.
No I Vaseline, King of the Hill.
I love them, but Gabe. 100 bars, 120 bars, 240. The whole Stop Snitching tape, 300 bars. Didn't he do like a 400 bars? Like,
bro, yeah. That nigga was.
That's too much.
Till this day, bro. What is it? Banks is a bitch. 50 is a bitch.
Yeah.
Olivia's a bitch. No, wait.
Olivia's a man.
Big, know it. Then just for that, man. Like, that nigga.
Yeah, it gotta be game.
300 bars.
Hey, Ghost Unit was probably my favorite West Coast mixtape.
Yeah. Oh,
shit.
Well, shit, I mean, during that mixtape era, wasn't it only Game? Who else was putting out mixtapes during that era?
Chameleon Air. Oh, in terms from of hip-hop or in general?
Yeah, from the West. The West. Shit.
I don't know.
No I want to say really. Game until TDE came out.
Fucking Spider-Loke.
Spider-Loke, yeah.
Hey, he don't count because he got his ass whooped.
Oh, yeah, he did.
Take him out of there.
Hey, did he get punched while he was DJing?
Yeah, did he get beat up by Game or that was 40
Glock? Yeah, by Game. Game beat up 40 Glock too. Remember he filmed it?
Hey, somewhere in that time, Joe Budden got punched too. Like,
Game was just punching niggas, fucking bully.
the 40 Glock one is funny because then he ended up turning around and suing him.
Yeah, he did sue him.
Yeah.
That shit is funny.
Yeah.
Game was on a tear. I'm trying to think, is that the most impressive like carry of a coast ever? Kane?
Yeah.
Has anybody else had to carry a coast?
No.
Similar to that? I don't think so. Outkast maybe in the 90s, but
what about Jeezy?
It would be somewhere in Texas. It would be somewhere in Texas that was similar.
I feel like Texas was everybody was during the same era. Like
no one in Texas. I think
maybe UGK in Texas.
Like
UGK maybe.
But I consider all that the South. So because I think. Yeah. I think Jeezy really like because Gucci Mane was already out, but I think Jeezy made it mainstream.
Yeah, but T.I. and
but that's Luda. What I'm saying. So, like, Luda too. I forgot.
Yeah, like T.I., Luda, Lil Jon, like they was all It was all pretty heavy. And I don't think anybody from the East has ever had to carry the coast. Jay for a little bit after Big died, but Nas came back around. X was there. Yeah, Mobb Deep was still there. I don't think anybody's ever had to carry a coast like Game.
Yeah, that's true.
And to do it like that is crazy.
Yeah.
He legit was a one-man wrecking crew.
Maybe M for the Midwest?
In for the Midwest? Who in the early 2000s? Who from the Midwest or who's from that north?
No, I don't consider M like carrying the coast like that. M was like his own. M was
because before Kanye, who else was rocking up there?
Common.
Yeah.
Talib.
Talib is from New York.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. What am I thinking?
Yeah. I mean, M, but that's not really, you know, carrying a coast like that. And plus, M, you know, was with Dre. It's like a different coast, like a collab.
Yeah.
What about Dipset for New York?
Yeah, Dipset, they held shit down in New York for a minute, but I mean, Jay was around, Nas was around.
Yeah, they had.
Yeah, I don't think New York has never really left until recently.
they gone.
Yeah, New York is real dormant minus Griselda right now. But I mean, Griselda with New York right now, because
I don't think they're carrying it though.
No,
I don't think so.
Petey Pablo held down North Carolina
until Cole came.
What would you even consider that? That's the Atlantic.
Yeah, I don't know.
Not the South. That's just
that's some backwoods.
Which is by himself, bro.
Lonesome. Hey, PD Pablo got off on that Sierra song, though. What was that shit called?
Yeah, he did. Man.
Hey, there's so many lost artists from like that early 2000s era.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
So many.
Who's a lost artist from the West Coast that you thought was gonna blow up but didn't?
Shade Shiest.
Oh shit. I still play that shit.
Shade Shiest's album was low key straight. Yeah, he was singing before all these niggas right now.
Man, I'm trying to think of I completely forgot about him.
Was Smiles and South Star from the West Coast?
No, they were from like.
I remember Smiles and South Star. Though.
I'm trying to think who is.
What was that group from Atlanta? They were signed to DTP. It was a light skinned dude, a dark skinned dude. One of them was bald. Any other time, damn, what was that shit called?
Hey, wait, we
DTP. Real quick, I'm looking it up.
We forgot about Cypress Hill. Isn't Cypress Hill West Coast?
Cypress Hill is 100% West Coast.
Yeah,
that's for sure. Him? Cypress Hill definitely gets an honorable mention. From the West, a forgotten artist. Are the East Siders a forgotten artist?
No, I mean,
y'all consider it? No, not really. They was on pretty, you know, a good time. Hold on, I'm about to tell you right now. He was on some of Snoop shit. He was on The Last Meal.
Hitman? Oh no, never mind.
Hitman, yeah. Hitman kind of low key never got on. Butch Cassidy.
Who was homie that was he's a West Coast artist too, but he was from Cash Money. The nigga with the braids. The singer.
Oh, the nigga that stabbed his eye out.
Oh, baby.
Didn't he stab his eye out? I don't know if that's the same person. I ain't going.
You talking about Houston?
Houston, yeah. Houston, low-key, watch. I'm about to look it up.
He's from the West Coast?
I don't know. Houston was Houston was on that one with, oh, I-20. Remember I-20 from
the I-20, movie? Yeah, I-20.
I-20.
Yeah, I-20. He had that deep voice, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, he had that deep voice.
Nah, who for,
Yeah, bro, this is Houston now. Damn. Yeah, bro stabbed his eye out. Yeah, he tried to commit suicide again.
Got that McDonald's check, though.
Yeah. He had a I-20 and was that Nate Dogg? I like that. I like that. Yeah, that was Nate Dogg. That's crazy. Man. Houston.
I'm trying to think of a West Coast artist. Hey, would you consider Exhibit West Coast, right?
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
I mean, New Mexico ain't that far. Hey, did you hear the story about like how people found out they was at the West Coast convention and somebody just yelled it out and it was like what? Like people was like, oh shit, what the fuck, you not from the West? Like an exhibit from New Mexico.
Hey, how do you think he reacted?
That's like telling nigga Santa Claus ain't real. Like what?
Yeah, like for real.
I would have been so high if I was exhibit. Like,
yeah, right. If you're exhibit, you're like, what the fuck?
Yeah, like,
no, hands up.
Oh my gosh.
Never mind that guy. Everybody talks trash.
This is too funny.
Hey, where's Coolio from?
Coolio probably from like Arizona or some shit.
But he if my mama think my mind. Think my mind.
Hey, Coolio from the West for sure. That reminds me of the story with Coolio. He tried to crowd surf and nobody caught him. Yeah, there's a story. Coolio tried to crowd surf and nobody caught him and he got stumped out and they ran his pockets at his own concert.
To his own song? First off, you can't try to crowd surf the Gangsta's Paradise.
Yeah, like, I don't know what song, but he got stumped out and got his pockets ran at his own shit.
Sugar Free to me, my personal opinion, Sugar Free is... in my top five from West Coast, personally.
Sugar Free, yeah.
I see Sugar Free live, and that was probably one of the best shows I've ever seen.
It's same here, bro. Hey, I saw him in Long Beach, the shore, where it used to be Marina Pacifica. PCH and Second. My gosh.
Yeah, that song "Speed" with DJ Quick and Sugar Free is like my top 10 West Coast song.
Yeah. Yeah, now West Coast just something different.
Yeah,